You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show. We talk all about model monitoring for LLMs with Will Buchanan. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're talking all about model monitoring for LLMs with my friend Will Buchanan. Will, how you doing, my friend?
I'm doing well. How are you, Seth?
Fantastic. So tell us who you are and what you do.
I'm a product manager on the Azure AI Responsible AI team, and I specifically focus in deployment scenarios such as deployments and monitoring in production.
Okay, so here's a question that I have, and because I've heard the LLM model monitoring before, but I've also, my understanding is that the model is fixed, like OpenAI's GPT-3, the model's GPT is fixed. Are we monitoring the model, or what's the situation here? What problem are we solving?
Great question. As you said, the model itself is fixed, but what changes is the production data. Your consumer behavior might change, or someone's trying to, say, make your model go off the rails in a production scenario, and you want to be able to ensure that it is acting in accordance with the evaluations that you deemed good to go in the first place.
That's cool. And so let's, why don't you take me through the process? Because obviously my understanding is we're building like ChatGPT style applications. How does one, because you said you want to make sure the evaluations are working. Can you walk us through the process of how one would get started doing this real quick and then take us to the end? Because everyone always talks about prompt engineering, but they never talked about like what this stuff looks like once you've deployed it.
Great. Happy to. Yeah, let me pull something up.
All right. Let me get your screen here, bud.
So here you see Azure ML prompt flow. And what this is this is a cloned template that we have in the library. And it's where you ask Wikipedia something. And it provides augmented question and answering as trained on Wikipedia. So you can see your inputs, your outputs, your URL. And specifically, you can see at the bottom the prompt that you're giving this generative AI model. This is a GPT-4 deployment. And so what you want to do is you want to be able to create a deployment. So here we have a button where you can deploy, and I'll walk you through the process. So let's say,
as you're going there, can I ask a question? So you basically in prompt flow, because we've done a lot of prompt flow on the AI show, you basically, this is like, you've already built the thing, you're comfortable with it. The prompts seem to be working. This is where, now we go to this step. Is that right?
Yes. This is when you're ready to bring it into production.
Got it.
And so in production, you're creating a deployment. And what you need to do is you need to enable inferencing data collection and app insights here. As you navigate through, you'll see the outputs. So let's say you return the answer or the context, which is user provided, to determine that you're responding, your model is responding with the factual information that you might want in your application.
Can you go back one step just out of curiosity? So when you're looking at inferencing data collection, what is it that it's collecting? And then on the application insights, what is it sending there? Just out of curiosity.
Yeah, great question. So inferencing data collection is specifically the request and response to your endpoint. And so that's the inputs and outputs to your model. So it all comes as part of the payload. So what we do is we collect that to your blob store, and then we perform analysis on that data.
Okay.
And the app insights is specifically for your operational metrics. Let's say CPU utilization.
That makes sense.
Way to turn,
you're covering
on
like the input, the what's coming into the request. It's going through the whole prompt flow. An output comes out from the LLM. You're keeping track of those things, and then you're also keeping track of like hardware utilization to make sure the CPU isn't spiking. You don't need to create a new deployment, kind of thing. Am I getting that right?
Exactly. It's all a right. Monitoring is just a place to look at different signals that are coming into your model.
Got it. Cool. Let's keep going.
Great. So once you've created it, you have a connection for your endpoint itself, and then you specify your compute, and you hit deploy. And so fast forward about 10 minutes, you now have a working deployment. And so in this, I have my endpoint. In the test tab, you can enter in something like this. And let's say I wanted to know about Alexander von Humboldt's cyanometer work. You can test your endpoint. And once it responds, you can then see the collected data. And so this model, given the prompts it was given, doesn't actually answer, doesn't hallucinate an answer here. It says, I don't know, which I really like.
That's cool.
So you've just done that. Now you actually want to be able to look at your data. So within the data asset, which automatically shows up, you can see your data. So this is the model inputs. And so in here, it's a JSON lines format, and you can see, okay, let's test it out.
Yeah, so as you're going, just a quick question, and yeah. Then you'll probably have to zoom into that so we can see it's a little fuzzy for us. So what you're showing is, and if I understood this right, basically, when you asked it the Alexander question, it captured, here, let me show our face, that way people can see. So it captured the input request, and then it went through whatever internal things it did, and it captured the output request, and it's putting it into an Azure ML data set right now. Is that what I'm looking at?
Correct, as a data asset. So you have your model inputs and your model outputs.
One thing we do
behind the scenes with this data collector is we generate a correlation ID, which joins your inputs and your outputs. And so our system handles that automatically.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, because otherwise you'd have a set of questions and a set of answers, and you'd have to somehow map them, but that correlates them together. Okay, cool. Cool. Exactly. Keep going. Sorry about that.
No, of course. So now that you've verified you have your data collected, you want to monitor it. So let's go to a monitor. Here, I'll switch over. So in the monitoring tab on the left side, you can then create a monitor. So in this, you choose your deployment, let's say this one, and you choose your task type. And so specifically, it's prompt and completion, AKA question and answer.
Got it.
You walk through the wizard, and here you can see the data assets. It's automatically scraping that, the inputs and the outputs. And as I said, it joins it on that correlation ID. Then you can define your workspace connection. And this would be your default Azure OpenAI connection for your workspace. And so then you can choose your deployment name. And this is actually the same one that you use for prompt flow. So it's quite simple.
Okay.
Then you can choose your production data asset window. Let's keep it at 7 days. And here's where it gets really interesting. If you only give your model inputs and collect only the outputs, then you can monitor for two metrics. They are coherence and fluency. But if you provide additional context, which is user-defined, you can ensure that your model is not hallucinating or providing answers that are irrelevant to that user-provided context. Does that make sense?
So let's pause right there, because this is a question that maybe I've struggled with or other people might struggle with. We don't have the right answer when it comes to, like there's no, like, I don't know. I know there's the question that here. Let me show my face so people can see it. So there's like the question comes in and the answer comes out. What are we actually testing? Because we don't know what the right answer is, or if it is the right answer. You mentioned something about context. Can you walk us through kind of what these things are testing in production? Because we, like, in general machine learning, you know, you have like the answer and you can see is the answer the right answer, and then that's how you score. What are we actually scoring here?
So. Great question. Some of the metrics that we're doing are GPT assisted metrics. So you have a very powerful model like GPT-4 that is given specific prompts, and then it provides evaluations. It scores the outputs. And so we have a suite of metrics which are used in the evaluation stage. The first one is groundedness. It's a really, really important one to make sure your model is not hallucinating. So it can come from a scale of 1 to 5. And so you'd use it when you're worried that your app generates information that's not part of the trained knowledge. Let's say you have a retail chatbot and you don't want it to pull information or fabricate something.
Right.
Similar to relevance as well. This would be if you expect high utility for your generative AI system and you want the answers to really enhance user experience. As I said, if you provide only the inputs and the outputs, then you can measure the coherence and fluency. And it's exactly what it sounds like. Uh-huh. Is your model coherent, or is it babbling on incomprehensibly like I might be now? Or fluency, is it speaking in halting language that is not really valuable for a user? So there are 5 metrics that you get out of the box. And so what I just showed in the monitoring wizard, wherever it is a configuration. So when you add an additional set of metrics, then you type in your context, and you would know this in your flow stage.
I see. And so if as you're building these prompts, you're cognizant of what these metrics might be, and we'll obviously hopefully put documentation up so people can get to that somehow. Yep. If you build your prompts a certain way, you'll not only be able to test for these things when you're developing them, but you'll be able to test for them in production, because what we're doing is we're setting up a model monitor on the data collected from the ins and the outs at inference time, or at, you know, with the when deployment time. Am I getting this right?
Well said. Exactly.
Cool. All right, let's keep going.
Great. So this is important. You can set up notifications for whoever wants to receive any alerts, and then you can review your parameters. And once you've created your monitor, then you can see your monitoring list. And let's fast forward, let's say, a week in production. At this point, you now have a monitor that's been running. And here's the dashboard that we've built. And so in it, you see the details of what you've been monitoring and your schedule. And so what it is under the hood is a pipeline. It runs on a user-defined cadence, and it'll tell you when your next run is, as well as what signals you've configured. And in here, we have an overview, which is for GSQ means generation, safety, and quality. So these are the grouping of these metrics that we provide. And so in it, you can then zoom in to your signals, and you can view the histogram of these metrics over time. And so this hasn't been operating in production for very long, but you can see you're passing and you're failing according to that threshold. And what you have is a pass rate, which is passing or failing. What's the percentage of total rows that have come in that will provide that to you?
This is cool. So basically what you've done is you've taken the measurements that you've used ostensibly during development time, at least we hope, mm-hmm. but you've moved them into production so that you can monitor these things ongoing. Because we might have assumed in our test set that users were going to be nice. And if they're not going to be nice, we want to know right away. This will alert you on a daily basis, or how often does, well, whatever trigger setting you have for the monitor. Is that right?
Correct. You can define it to run as frequently as you want. This could be running continuously. It would be asynchronously run. It uses batch behind the scenes.
Okay.
And actually, what I'm showing right now on my screen is the pipeline that powers all of this. So this is the monitoring backend, and you'll see a list of jobs associated with your monitor. Let's say, let's dive into this one. It's your job history. And I'll show you what a successful one is. And you have your model inputs and your outputs. And as I said, we join the data, and then you calculate metrics. And these metrics are the same evaluation metrics and the components that have been used earlier in the lifecycle. And then we push the metrics to the UI where you can consume it.
That's cool. So under the hood, this is all running like Azure ML standard monitoring that we do for regular models, but now for prompt engineered models.
Exactly.
That's amazing. That's cool. And like I said, I think the cool bit about this is like we build these things with the best of intentions. We build all this test. But if it goes off the rails, it's nice to have that security blanket of knowing that it will alert you if something is incorrect.
Exactly. And that gives you the peace of mind to deploy your application and let it run in production environments.
So this is really cool stuff. Where can people go to find out more about this?
We have a pretty great set of documentation that we just published. I would encourage you to visit that. I think the link is in the screen.
There you go.
We'd love to have you to try this out. It's a really rich and robust offering, and we're looking to get collect more feedback.
Amazing.
Some exciting announcements coming up too at Microsoft Ignite.
Oh, this is cool. And so, okay. So go try it out. Take a look at this. Make sure it works for you. Will, thank you so much for spending some time with us, my friend.
Thanks for having me. Good to see
you. Awesome. Thank you so much for watching. We're learning all about model monitoring for LLMs, peace of mind. When putting out your own copilots, make sure you use it. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully we'll see you next time. Take care.